I founded Science Journal for Kids because I firmly believe that every student has the right to understand the world around us. As a science teacher myself, I knew how difficult it is to find high quality science teaching resources, which are free. Usually there are paywalls, you have to subscribe. So from day one, I wanted to make sure that all of our content is always going to be free.
My students are starting to come into their own now. And I feel like Science Journal for Kids really hits that sweet spot of allowing them to access not just kind of the fun of science, but the science of science, the academics of what it means to do scientific research. Accessing the articles couldn't be simpler. The search tools are there. Maybe it's standards you're looking for, age group, reading level, topics. So it's very straightforward and easy and pretty intuitive to get to the article that you need. There's lead-in videos, there's extra resources, there's vocabulary. So the articles are simplified in the way that the language is used so that my kids in grade 7 can comprehend and achieve a connection to what they're reading. But it doesn't take the science away. We have graphs that the kids can look at. There's data charts, there's data tables. They're colorful, well laid out. And so the kids really get into referencing the images and the graphs in a way that is meaningful using the accurate vocabulary.
Even though the article was written by scientists, it was still very easy to understand. I really enjoyed reading about this topic.
The most important thing is for students to learn how to answer questions using the scientific method, how a hypothesis is formed, how you design an experiment to answer the question in the hypothesis, how to collect data, how to interpret those data, and how to draw conclusions based on that. So we really want everyone to have access to the best scientific resources out there.